In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a connection from WinCC version 8 to KepWare, KepServerEX, OPCUA server. We will go into tag management, create that connection, and create a few tags, and then put them on a screen and go to runtime to make sure that we can read them. So let's get started. We're going to start in KepWare, and you can see that I'm running KepServerEX version 6. I like using this because it has a simulator so we can kind of test it out. And under the default channel 1 device 1, I've created a tag group called WinCC version 8 SBS demo, and I have a couple of tags in here. And just looking at the OPC QuickClient, you can see that we've got some data changing in these. So these are the tags that we're going to pull in. But there's a couple of things that we have to do first. I'll highlight the top level project and just do edit properties. And under OPC UA, I'm just going to make sure anonymous login is set to yes. I'm not going to create a username and password that connects to this. Also, if you go down in your system tray or look under your installed applications, look for your OPC UA configuration under KepWare. And this is the interface that you're going to get. The server endpoints that KepWare publishes, we have two on this machine, and they're both pointing to this instance of KepWare. One is using the loopback adapter 127.0.0.1, and it's using port 49.3.20. And I can double click on this to open it. And this is for a local connection if we want to use that. And I've got all my security policies for basic 256, 128. And to have a secure connection, I'm going to not check this none in secure. And this is the endpoint. This is what we use to connect from an OPC client, which is going to be WinCC, to this OPC UA server. So I'm going to right click and just copy that. Now, one other thing that we need to do is look at trusted clients, and I've loaded these from WinCC and trusted them here. And this is to tell KepWare that we are trustworthy. The OPC UA client is for runtime communication, and the tag importer is to allow us to connect and browse tags from tag management. If you don't have these, just choose import, and you're gonna go to this path, which is in program files, WinCC OPC UA client, and your two certs will be there. So you'll choose both of these, and then when you load them, you'll just select them, and there will be a trust button here that you just hit trust, and you can do that. So that will allow you to get these trusted client certificates in and trusted. Now, there's one other thing that we have to do is we have to create a certificate from the server, and you can see I've already generated one. Basically, if you export this certificate, you want to, after you create it, go to the path WinCC OPC UA client and make sure that the certificate is under the trusted certifications. And if you make any changes, like if you create the certificate and put it here, if you make any changes at all, it says that you have to reinitialize runtime. If you don't reinitialize runtime, it will not connect, even if your certificate's in the right place. So once you generate the certificate, put it so the WinCC client can find it, then what you'll do is just click close. And we'll go back to KepWare, and under runtime, you'll just do reinitialize, and it will stop and restart runtime. Then we can open up tag management. And just like before when we loaded the S7 protocol suite, we can right click, add new driver. This time we're going to choose the OPC UA WinCC channel, and this is a client connection. And we're going to right click and do new connection, and I'll just give it a name. And then I will right click connection parameters. And under custom discovery, I'm just going to double click and I'm going to paste that endpoint right in here. And I'll click OK. It'll recognize that. And then under security policy, I'm just going to choose which option I want. And I think the most secure is a 256 SHA and sign and encrypt. And we're using an anonymous connection. And I'll click OK. If I've done everything right, I should be able to right click and do browse, and it will browse the server. So we will just kind of browse to the tags that we have. There's our WinCC step-by-step demo. It shows you the addresses, and you can add these in manually if you want. That's the address of these tags. So you got your namespace of 2, and then your path shows channel 1 device 1, V8 SBS demo.rejected.produced. Here, I can just check these, and these will add these directly to this connection. And then I'll hit my network back sign here. And then if we look under tags, you'll see that we've created these tags here. And if we want, we could add these to a group. I'll just call it kept tags. And then if I go over to these tags, I can move over to the group. It should allow me to choose that, and I can just kind of move these down. So now I have these tags within a WinCC connection. And the next thing that I want to do, if I just want to check and make sure I can read these tags, we'll go back to Graphics Designer, and I'm just going to create a quick screen and throw these on there and make sure I can read and write these tags. So I've got Graphics Designer open, and I'll just save this page as KepWare OPC UA test, just to test that I have these. And then I'm just going to make this picture small so it's just not gigantic. And I can use my tag browser to find my tags. So here's my KepWare. There's kept tags, and I can just grab these and throw them out on the screen. And the browser, I think, puts them out in reverse order. We have to actually go look at the I/O field. So this is my produced, that's rejected, and that's my production speed. So just to kind of keep everything organized, I'll add some labels here. And I like to turn off the global color scheme to these. Kind of a light gray. So I can save these, and then we'll just activate runtime and make sure we can talk to them. And so, yep, we can see produced is kind of climbing, and rejected is climbing at a different rate. If I open up my quick client and just kind of superimpose it here, all right, so you can see that the values are matching up. And the production speed I'm not simulating. I can just put in, say, I'll just put 56 in there. And you can see that it's written here. And of course, I could do a write back to it and put something like 44. And you can see it writes back to it. So pretty simple, just a few steps. The biggest thing is getting the certificates in place. And if you go to the WinCC help file, under communications, there is a pretty good help file on how to do the OPC UA channel, basically how to take care of the certificates, where you get everything. Just kind of read through this. It tells you how to look at the certificates, where to put them and everything. So it's a great resource to understand how these things work. Okay, so that's it for this. Thanks for watching.